Jones' tattoo experience in Ottawa was tainted by some unfortunate circumstances. We will provide some recommendations so this doesn't happen to anybody else.
Exactly how long it's gonna be, because important to me, but you're the boss, okay? I just drive the car.
So you ready?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. So. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Okay. Cool. So as soon as I get her attention, then I can get a quote for you on this. Because then here we have. Alright, you wanted butterflies originally too, right?
Yeah.
And then I killed your butterflies. I'm kidding. But yeah, so this is the style still?
Yeah.
Make sure your tattoo artist and the shop owner are on the same page with regards to pricing relative to your desired finished product. Research your tattoo artist and make sure they work at a speed you are comfortable with. Some artists require a lot of setup and or break time, which could increase the time to complete your tattoo and in turn lead to the shop requiring additional payment. A way to avoid issues is to ensure that the cost to complete the tattoo is not conditional upon time in. Get this in writing. So how's the pain been so far?
It's very painful.
It's very painful?
Yeah.
Really? Are you like...
But manageable pain.
Oh, manageable pain. You're gritting your teeth?
No.
You can take it?
No,
I can take it. All right. Pay for your tattoo in full up front. It is typical for shops to ask for a deposit or a partial payment. Paying in full can lead to being in a situation where the tattoo has not been completed to your satisfaction, with little recourse to settle on what was agreed. keep your tattoo at a business casual level. Don't get too personal. Getting too close to the artist could have adverse effects on the overall tattoo experience. More talking than actual tattooing. You can feel the connection without divulging your life story. As this day came to a close, expectations were that the tat would be finished. Unfortunately, it was not, but we were assured that a finisher session would be scheduled. When it came to that time, we were told that our artist was no longer working at the shop and that we would have to book with another at additional cost or pursue the artist herself. Well, we found her.
So what's happening in Mahalco today?
Translation of my tattoo.
Yes, day two of the tattoo. We switched shops. We're heading here on Dalhousie looking for the spot. Anyways, we'll see you in there. Is anybody home?
Feel the blood creeping up from the heathens. Got will, got fight, got pride, got reason. If they wanna go eat, then you know I'm gonna feed them. If you're coming for me, hope you're ready for a demon. I got eyes in the back of my head, I'm seeing. Take me for granted and you know I'm leaving. I'ma take what's mine with the webs I'm weaving. I could take this crowd from seeing to believing. Got a taste for blood and my tongue keeps bleeding. From the words I spit, so sharp, so freezing. So cold, behold, frostbite. They feeling I could tear you apart or I could go heal them. Don't believe in faith, don't believe in ceilings. I just need a taste and my mind starts peeling. I don't pace myself, I grind on kneeling.
From this experience, we learned that asking for references would have proved beneficial in crystallizing one's decision on which shop to deal with, and most importantly, the artist that would be gifted the opportunity to have their art on your skin. As it stands, Geraldine's tattoo has yet to be finished to her satisfaction. The artist had some personal issues to deal with, and we haven't heard from her since. It will most likely be completed in the Philippines. Thank God we are moving there this summer.
I'll soon be with it. I live life for the fight. Yeah, I'm here to get it. I got drive.